In that last cutscene, Link for some reason looked frozen. I don't know why. But the Master Sword is back to its true power. It has a glow and has a golden emerald thing. Gemstone, whatever. Not bad. It is now very capable of kicking ass. So this is the last part of the game. We're gonna be collecting the Triforce Charts. And, oh, I never showed this. And it's gonna be kind of tedious. And the submarine chart. I don't know what the Hylian text says, but I think we've gone almost all of them, but the one in the bottom right corner, which is a required island. Actually, I believe. Oh, wait, no, it's not. But it's near one of the Triforce charts, anyway. One is right near us as well. The one in the top right. And there is also one in the ghost ship. So this is pretty much the last stretch. It's tedious, really. I'm not gonna lie. I agree with everyone who says it is. I don't even think I have all the treasure charts, which kind of sucks. Because it would be really nice if I had all of them at this point. Or at least I'd be getting all of them as I got the Triforce charts. But I don't think that's possible. I'm going to have to probably go a bit out of my way to get them. Where's that other chart? There might be treasure here? I'm going to check. There should be. Wait, I never got that? I thought I got the treasure on Bomb Island. No, there is no treasure. I didn't have it. I don't have the chart for this. Huh. So I'm gonna meet you all here, and then we're gonna have her here, and then here. I think maybe there's a big Octorok here? Not sure. That makes sense. But I actually can't tell from where I am. We do have some towers over there, however. Man, this is kind of painful. And fail. Farther. No cannons? That's interesting. There might be treasure there. I'm pretty sure map corresponds here. Unless I corresponded to the other archipelago. No, it's an Isles, whatever. Wait. No enemies? Really? That is very odd. Well, what's the point then? Oh, hi! That was it? A different colored... Actually, I like the colors on that wizard. It looks pretty cool. But really, that was it? What the... Whoa! People one-shotting the wizards. More importantly, there's these kinds. A little high! Nice! Okay then, just some fancy looking Riz ropes. Like I'm not used to them at this point, I have my freaking fully powered massive sword. Another treasure chart. Let's see where this corresponds to. We might be going there later. Do I have one for this island? That's for the archipelago. No, that looks like it, but that can't be. I can't even see anything now. Barely dodged that. Doesn't look like there's really anything here. Yeah, no treasure, no nothing. So with that, I'll meet you all over here. I think a chart corresponds here. And I think I've said that for a lot of islands, and they never actually have any. Well, go on and try and Forks. A lot of the seamen that are on islands where there are Triforce Charts, they'll basically mention them as a try and Forks. I don't really know why. Where Nintendo came up with that? I'm pretty sure there is treasure here. Let's look. Of course I'm wrong, as always. This is what I'm talking about. I was really hoping that by this point, I would be able to, you know, just when I arrive at a Triforce Chart, I can get the treasure there, and... God. And then it would be good. Whoa! That was cool. Don't hit me! I surrender! That was an unintentional kill. Oh my god, when did it become so accurate? God! Those guys are pretty close to hitting me. I'm amazed and kind of impressed. Oh, this is pretty simple. We're just gonna go in, kill a bunch of enemies, and not a lot else to it. Damn it. So I think I'm just gonna speed up this, and yeah, I will see you all in a bit whenever I'm done here. Cue epic music! And after that train wreck of a fight, as always, we're done. I recommend when you're gonna be hitting the pillars, which have the Tower of the Gods on them, the heads of the Statue of the Gods, actually, I believe the final one you get. What I'm saying is that the head of the final statue in the Tower of the Gods, the head is on there, but anyway, I don't know why, but I recommend you have full health before you start hitting the pillars, because usually you'll usually get a heart instead if you don't. Like if you have like even only one heart gone. I love how most of the darkness were actually hitting each other in the home. Something else that caught my attention when I was at the Wind Temple. It's not really that windous besides using the Digweave and all that. It's more Earthish, really. It's a bit more Earthish than the Earth Temple itself. Kind of weird. It's kind of like the Forest Temple, which was originally going to be associated with wind in Ocarina of Time. Oh no, that's just me. But, you're probably wondering, when happens when you're about to open a Triforce chart? Yeah. I don't know. I'm guessing it's in Hylian, and that we can't ask the King Red Lions to help us. Where did I leave the King of Reliance? Oh, there you are. So I'm going to now meet you all over here. Cutting ahead. So there are a lot of seagulls here, circling around the area. And I went over to them, but there was nothing there. There was no big octo, no nothing. Yeah. I don't know. It really looks like there should be. Maybe I'll actually check. Because I really do think there should be one here. I'll just check before we go in. No, you see that? Do you see how many there are? But there was none. I went over there before off on the way here. I was thinking, okay, I'll start off here with that big Octorok. But there was none. Whoa! That was funny. I lift him up and then he, like, dies. I like how the freaking mini blends can actually walk through the fire. What are they, sane or something? Like, really? Or are they just the spawns of Satan? And there are mini blends in there. At least it looked like there were. Yeah, there are. This part of the game really is kind of boring, I'm not gonna lie. There's not really a whole lot to what I mean. Oh, platform chart. Kind of useless. I mean, there's nothing, really. I mean, when you fail to reach Greyfish House in time, that was interesting. Very interesting part of the game. You're basically kind of racing against time to put you out of your misery. You're basically racing against time to get to Jaboon before the pirates could, and the Great Sea was cursed. It was permanently at night, permanently raining, all of that. Yeah, not a whole lot to it. So the main purpose of this area is a minigame. Let me just, because I'm always paranoid on if or if not there's a chart nearby. This one really looks like it could be for flight control pad. However, but I'm always paranoid if or not there's going to be a chart that corresponds to the island I'm at. So I'm going to check. Because I usually kick myself for not going there. Or not checking, then realizing I failed. Pretty sure we've gone nearly, if not all, of the platforms. Yeah, I'm almost 100% sure. Actually, I'm really curious on if or if not there is a big Octorok here, so I'm gonna check quickly. Okay, I checked, and there is no big Octorok. I was correct. This can be a kind of difficult minigame, honestly. This is almost impossible to do without the double magic upgrade. And there's a postbox here for some reason. These guys are not actually Rito, they're just imitators. That's like just a mask they have on, really. you can actually use the Tingle Balloon to get a boost. But other than that, you have really nothing else to use. So, let's do it! Collect, get every updraft you can, and also watch your magic. Rapidly press whatever button is... Oh, God! The wind is against me! I'm a dumbass, I forgot the wind direction was any other way. Shut up! It was in the exact opposite direction. I can't believe I did not think of that. But maybe it'll adjust itself. At least they refill your magic for free. Okay. Let's try this for real. Hoo-ah! I knew something was up when I was going so slow. The real challenge is just hitting the updrafts on the way. Hopefully I can hit this. Oh crap, I am totally gonna fail. Come on. Oh. That is bullshit. Did you see that? I missed by like a smidgen. A smidgen. That was literally a smidgen! Let's try this again. You're making it this, or not. Word of advice, if you think that you can just use your sword at the very end to get a bit more distance, it's not really worth it. You won't really get that much. Damn it! No! Get over here! Crap. Ah! I thought I wouldn't have a hard time, because this isn't that hard, it's just annoying. Because those friggin' updrafts don't go. But, okay. If you think that drawing the Master Sword at the end will help, it doesn't really help that much. You get, like, only a foot. It's still worth it, but don't expect to get that far. Come on. Yes! Okay. We should be good. I'm gonna see if I can hit this one. Or not. Come on. If I can hit this, I'll be very... Oh god. Oh crap. Come on. Go. Go, baby, go! Go! Oh my god, I hit that! That was insanely close! I literally ran out of magic just as I hit it! Whew! I only hit one updraft, wow! Yeah! Only 12 pieces remaining. And I'm just gonna speak to him so I can get my magic back up. Why can't I go down? Bah. Well, with that, I believe we are done for now. Next time, we are going to be heading to the islands over here. Maybe collect some treasure, because I think we have a chart that corresponds to Foreign Fairy Island. So, I will see you all next time. Thank you all for watching, and see you later.